Father, through the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we worship and adore you. Thank you, Lord, for this day, as we today remember and honor your daughter, Anna Hornbeckholm, who last year on this day died so peacefully. And as we celebrate her, remember her anniversary of the death to the entire family members, the sons and daughters, the grandchildren, and all the near and dear ones that they are here. But we give glory to you. She lived a beautiful life. She lived so close to you and raised up these beautiful children. And today, as she has come to you, bless her, Lord, with eternal rest. Today, as you said, told us the gospel, I will give you rest. We ask you to grant the same rest, the perpetual rest, the company of your saints and angels in heaven, to be seated at your right hand in glory with Anthony Dalgon and Anna Hornbeckholm together. May they be resting forever in your peace and in your love. Lord, as we also pray for their eternal bliss, we also remember and pray for the family, the entire sons and daughters, who do wonderful service to your church, who dedicate their time, their talent and their resource, and all their who heavily labor for the church and to keep the church so beautiful. Lord, bless their good heart, bless the family, bless all the children in the family, bless every one of them with good health of mind and body, peace, joy and happiness. And bless the children who are studying with wisdom and knowledge. And bless all those who are working, that they be have the good hand, good strength to work and go on to look after themselves and to look after the whole family. Lord, together, bless this family of Dawn and bless all their intentions, bless all their heartfelt desires. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And we pray together in Vietnam, our Father.
Lạy Cha chúng con ở trên trời, chúng con nguyện đem Cha cả sáng, nước Cha chỉ đến, ý Cha thể hiện dưới đất cũng như trên trời.
Xin Cha cho chúng con hôm nay được sống.
Con xin cha để chúng con xa trước cám dỗ, xin cứu chúng con cho khỏi sự dữ. Kính mừng Maria, đầy ơn phúc Đức Chúa Trời ở cùng bà, ta có phúc nở hơn mọi người nữa, và Giêsu con lòng bà vùng phúc nở. Mẹ Chúa Trời cầu cho chúng con mà kẻ có tội khi nay và trong giờ thân sẽ. Amen.
The Son, the Holy Spirit, as it was the beginning, is now, and shall be, world without end. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Anna Hornbeckholm and Anthony Dalgon, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you. ourselves, ask the Lord's mighty blessings upon ourselves, our family members, and all those who asked our prayers. We offer this Mass for all our brothers and sisters suffering with coronavirus in different parts of the world, and all those who care for them. May the Lord grant them speedy recovery, comfort and courage. And may the Lord bless all of us who are worried, filled with anxieties. May we be able to overcome our life and be given rest from all our burdens from our Master Jesus. On this day we also offer this Mass for all the souls of the faithful departed, being the death anniversary of Anna Holmbig Holm, the first death anniversary, and Anthony Dowdown, also being the death anniversary of Joanna Commodore and Wolf. May the Lord grant unto them eternal rest. The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge the Lord's pardon and forgiveness for all our human failures. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Who the abasement advancement of your Son have raised up a fallen world. Fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the prophet Zechariah. The Lord says this, "Rejoice, heart and soul, daughter of Zion. Shout with gladness, daughter of Jerusalem. See now, your king comes to you. He is victorious. He is triumphant, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will banish chariots from Ephraim and horses from Jerusalem. The bow of war will be banished. He will proclaim peace for the nations. His empire shall stretch from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit, you put an end to the misdeeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal Him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today, as the whole world is filled with anxieties, fear, worry, and fear of COVID-19, what a consoling word Jesus our Savior gives to all of us, and what a beautiful invitation that God gives to us on this 14th Ordinary Sunday. The Lord calls you and me so beautifully. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Yes, my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. During the days of the Second Vatican Council, Pope John 23rd used to submit all his anxieties to God with this prayer every night. He used to pray, Lord Jesus, I am going to bed. It is your church. Take care of it. Yes, my brothers and sisters, that is what every one of us today are called to do. Christ our Lord calls us saying, come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. The background of this if we go back to the background of the gospel, it is because in the time of Jesus, the so-called religious leaders, the Pharisees and the scribes, were putting too many religious burdens on every day on the people. There were too many laws and regulations, too many conditions and controls, and every day an ordinary people were suffering of the Sabbath laws and customs. There comes Jesus, who saw the people like sheep without a good shepherd, and he had compassion for them and said, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." Yes, my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today, at times, we also cry to God, "Lord, my burden is full and I am heavily loaded." But do we do anything regarding that? I'm reminded of a story that I read in this book written by Anthony DiMello, and he writes a story about a rabbi, an old rabbi, who prayed to God saying, "God, all my life I have dedicated and I serve only for you. Now, look at me. I am so poor, and please do something. Please let me win a lottery, and thus I will be happy." The rabbi waited for a while and nothing happened. And again he prayed to God, "God, help me to win a lottery." Months went by and nothing happened. And then he finally prayed to God saying, "God, I am in desperate need. Please do something." That night, God appeared to him and said, "Rabbi, I will let you win a lottery, but why don't you first buy a lottery?" Yes, my brothers and sisters, this is just a story. Please don't buy lottery unless you are the old rabbi. My friends, as we go to Jesus with our heavy burdens, he will definitely reduce our burdens and give us rest. If you go to the Old Testament, we meet so many God-fearing people and how their burdens were completely removed by God Almighty. For example, Abraham and Sarah, who were suffering without an offspring, but though for a long time, they were not blessed with their child, they never lost their faith in God. They cried out to him day and night at the age of 99. Abraham was blessed with Isaac because of his faithfulness and trust in God. His burden was completely removed. And as we move a little further, we meet with Job, who cried to God, "Naked I was born, and naked I will die." But he never lost hope in God. He went back to him again and again, and at the end, God highly blessed him. Though we are all filled with so many material things, they cannot give us permanent happiness and joy. God alone, yes, he alone gives us joy and happiness. Our heart will be restless until it rests in him. Yes, my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. At times in our life, when we are tested with trials, the first question we ask God is, why me? And we fail to count the innumerable blessings we receive from God each and every day. I am reminded about Arthur Ashe, who was an American professional tennis player who won 3 Grand Slams, single titles. This famous Wimbledon player was dying of AIDS due to his blood transfusion. Many of his fans and followers wrote a letter to him asking, why did God choose you for such a bad and cruel disease? An author, Ashe, replied them saying, world over, there are 5 million children start playing tennis, and only 500,000 learn to play tennis. And of the 500,000 play professional tennis, and there is only 50,000 come to the circuit, and there are only 5,000 reach the Grand Slam, and only 50 reach the Wimbledon, and 4 to the semi-finals, and 2 to the finals. When I was holding up the cup, I did not ask God, why me? And today in pain, I should not ask God, why me? Yes, my brothers and sisters, what a beautiful, inspirational life this great man lived. Great. His words is really meaningful to pray all of us. When we have all joys, happiness, we never ask God, why me? But when we have to face suffering, we do ask God, why me? So it is God who chose us, and let us thank and praise Him for the good things that are happening to us. And then let us go to Him also without pain and suffering. There He will unload our burdens and afflict our souls. Yes, my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, we need to unload our burdens on the Lord. This unloading is the main purpose of our personal and family prayers. And it is one of the functions of divine worship in the church. During our daily prayers in the evening, we ask God's forgiveness for the sins and failures of day and receive consoling assurance that we are reconciled to God and with our fellow human beings. And during the Holy Mass in our church, we place all our stress-filled lives on the altar and allow Jesus to cool down the overheated radiators of our hectic lives. We also unload the burdens of our sins and worries on the altar and offer them and ourselves to God during the Holy Mass. Jesus lays the light burden of His commandment of love on us and yokes us with Himself, giving His strength through the Holy Spirit to fulfill that commandment. And Jesus is also interested in lifting up our burdens that suck the life out of us, so that He can place around our necks His yoke, His own yoke that brings to us and to others through us new life, new energy, and new joy. We are called not only to find peace, refreshment, and rest for ourselves, but also to live kind of life through which others too may find God's peace, God's refreshing grace, and the joy of placing their lives in the hands of God. So my brothers and sisters, today, let us come to God and entrust totally our life, definitely. When we unload our burdens to our God, He will definitely give us rest, give us freedom from all our illness, from all our worries, and make us His loving sons and daughters. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us rise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, Christ invites us to come to Him with all that burdens us. In His name we offer our prayers.
We pray for Pope Francis and the bishops of our church. May they be strengthened by the Spirit in proclaiming the gospel to all the people. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all religious and civil leaders. At all levels, may they be led to a realistic collaboration to bring peace to the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Today, in preparation for Nailok Week, let us acknowledge and celebrate the history, culture, and achievements of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, and the many contributions they have made to this country. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for people struggling with worry and stress in their lives, especially those who have suffered abuse of any kind. May we, as members of your church, reach out to all in need to help lighten their burdens. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that all will continue to take care to avoid the risks of spreading the coronavirus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the sick find relief from their suffering in the peace of God. We pray especially for all who are sick from COVID-19. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that those who have died will live forever in Christ's loving embrace. We pray especially for Anna Huang Vic Hong, Joanna Comter, Anthony Duan Do, Wadiswawa Wolf, whose anniversaries occur about this time, and all those whose names are recorded in our parish remembrance book. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for ourselves in silence.
We praise you, O God, for all the ways in which you care for your people. Receive these prayers on behalf of those who seek healing and release from life's burdens. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
That my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to our Heavenly Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and thereby may bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light, and so, with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew falls.
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring them to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter Comensoli, the Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Remember and pray for all those who died due to this COVID-19, all those recently deceased members of our family and our parish community, and all whose names are recorded in our parish memorial book. Welcome them in the light of your eyes. Have mercy on all of us, we pray. We pray the Blessed Mother Virgin Mary. We bring to you, Lord, all our worries, anxieties, fears, the burdens of our life. We bring to you, Lord, the entire world. Help us, Lord, to trust in you. Be sure you will never let us down. When we surrender in faith and trust to you, you will look after us, Lord. Help us to trust in you. We pray the Blessed Mother Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you,"
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and joy of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we, called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy
to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Almighty and merciful God, you assure us that your hand is not too short to save, nor your ear too dull to hear our prayer. You have revealed that you are ever attentive to our supplications. Your children are under the grip of fear because of the fast-spreading coronavirus pandemic in the different parts of the world. Send the power of your word and calm the storms of fear and desperation. Father God, take authority over this present crisis that your children may live in peace and security. You are the Lord who heals us. Heal those affected and strengthen their afflicted families. Give courage and protection and comfort to the medical personnel taking care of the sick. May your grace and comfort surround the dying, and may their souls rest in peace. Holy Spirit, give wisdom and guidance to the scientists doing research, that they may develop an effective medicine to combat the sickness speedily. We pray for the government authorities, that they may take appropriate steps for the good of the world. Lord Jesus, we remember you said, God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. With the apostles, we cry out to you, Lord, save us, we are perishing. Let not this present crisis lead your children to fear and gloom. Let them rather turn their hearts to you, finding their hope in you, who is our refuge forever and ever. Amen.
And never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's all say together our parish prayer. God our Father, your parish family of St. Peter's is Kilo, thanks you for the faith we share. Make us a people who cares for one another and has a genuine concern for the wider community. Help parents to give the example and give children the grace of love and respect. Fill our youth with wisdom, hope and vision. Their leadership is the future of our church and nation. To our sick grandchild, to those of our 20 years eternity, and to those in sorrow, your peace and joy. Father, deepen our love and strengthen our faith. Jesus nourishes your word and Eucharist. Holy Spirit, direct us in all we do, and help us to say always, Lord, it is good for us to be here. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Let us go the peace and joy of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Thank you, my brothers and sisters. Have a lovely day, and may God bless you.
Thank you, Father.